Zach Wilson, I know, didn't play so well, right? 4 interceptions. And so you come away from that game thinking what about not only the Jets, but Zach Wilson overall?
Well, unfortunately, I've seen this before. And, you know, he didn't set a record. He did not set a record for most interceptions by a rookie.
No.
That would have been Mark Sanchez, who threw 5 of them bad boys, and I lived through that. So, to me, it's like, look, man, we can't panic right now. I already know how Kay feels about it. He wants to panic. I don't want to panic yet. I think as a coach, though, the first thing you better do as a coach is look in the mirror yourself. Don't point fingers at your young quarterback. This is the most talented quarterback the Jets have had since Joe Namath, in my opinion. Now, is he a polished guy? Hell no. But if you expected a rookie quarterback to come in here and dominate things, there's no way. It doesn't happen. All right, it's hard to win with a rookie quarterback. I understand. I went to a championship game with one, but that's a different story. But to me, I look at it this way. What did I do? And I got killed for this. Remember when I came up with the old, the little red light, yellow light, green light? Mm-hmm. I got killed for that thing. What the hell are you talking about, that traffic sign or whatever? Because I wanted to explain to my quarterback that, look, dude, we are in red. You understand, we can play defense. We have a chance in every game. We're going to win the game on defense and on special teams. Two phases of the game, I know we're better than our opponent. And so we can't mess it up. So if it's red, if you know you can throw a completion, throw it in there. If not, then run with it. All right, this is what I said. Yellow came, all right, hey, look, if you are pretty sure you can put it in there or whatever, just don't throw it to the other team. That was kind of yellow. Green, we got to let it rip. We never got to green. But anyway, Mark said, we never got to green. All right. But to me, just we got to be a little patient, but we got to do something that shows that, hey, look, understand it. Just because you have the ability to make every throw, sometimes it's not appropriate to make those throws. And look, we get it. Did this surprise anybody that New England, you know, dominated this game?
No, not at all. Rex, what surprised me, and you say from a panic standpoint, is I'm all for protection of the young quarterback. Oh, let's protect our young quarterback like the New England Patriots protect theirs. Let's be – you say you want boring sometimes, Robert Saleh, then be boring. He shouldn't drop back and be throwing 33 times no matter what the case may be. It's all about the head coach saying, I'm a defensive-minded guy. I got to shore up my strength, which is my defense. Mm-hmm. I got to figure out how to run the ball because they got some nice chunks here and there. And then methodically allow this young quarterback to dink and dunk, screen game here, screen game there, some underneath shallow crosses, quick outs, things of that nature, so he can understand the pro game opposed to green light, green light, green light, green light. You're not going to win like that.
I 100% agree with every single thing you said about it, because the first thing when you have a young quarterback, and especially when you know he's going to hesitate, it doesn't come out like it does with a veteran quarterback, like 1-2, bam. Right? Or it's boom, boom, boom. It doesn't happen that way, okay, with a rookie quarterback. Protection's the key. You talked about protecting the quarterback. It starts with protection and what you're asking them to do. How do you start a game? By letting it rip against the New England Patriots. You know, look at their quarterback. What did he throw the ball? 4 yards down the field the whole time? Yes. And by the way, you know what I mean?
He like, did exactly what he should have been doing.
But here's the difference. Right. This is one of the greatest coaches in the history of our game. All right, so that's on the other sideline. He is not going to expose this Mac Jones to anything like that. Hmm. All right? Here's the great thing. Everybody's quick to say, they got the next Tom Brady. No, they don't. Thank God they don't, being a Jet fan. All right? They don't. He's not Tom Brady. Now, he's smart. I mean, he's smart. He's going to make the right decisions and things like that. But he didn't have the skill set of a Tom Brady. And you know what? You know who knows that? Bill Belichick. Mm. And so he's going to go out, and he looks – does this kid not look like a veteran quarterback, though?
Well, he looks – you know what he looks like to me?
I'm going
to
take it.
He reminds me of young Tom Brady, first 2 Super Bowls. That's exactly what they did. Let him throw for a little bit less than 200 yards, a touchdown, don't turn the ball over. We're going to play defense. We're going to run the ball with Corey Dillon, with Antoine Smith, with Kevin Falk.
Right.
And that's how we're going to play.
Remember when the Steelers had Ben Roethlisberger?
Yes, early.
Would never throw it more than 20, 22 times a game. Their record was like unbelievable. As soon as he threw it more than that, whoop, that's a loss.
So how do you manage expectations for the Jets team, right? Because what happens as a fan, you start saying, well, this is the definition of insanity. Like, we're doing the same thing over. Like, we went through this process with Sam Darnold. You know, end up getting hurt. We moved on. I'm watching him destroy teams for the Panthers, right? Mm-hmm. Surrounded by weapons. And now I'm watching the same thing happen again to Zach Wilson.
Yeah, but I agree. But we got to understand that if it's about his development, then let him develop on a different pace. Don't just go out and assume that just because he can make those throws, he blows you away. That's because they're not hitting him in the practice field.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
They're not changing up coverages. They know you're going to be in cover three. You know what I mean? Like, it's easy to play against your own defense. You're not multiple on your defense. So to me, he doesn't have why is this quarterback for New England look better? Because he goes against a Bill Belichick defense every day. This guy's going against a cover three defense every day. So you've got to make sure that we understand that. And like you said, protect him.
Yeah.
Protect him from himself right now. Because look, but here's the great thing. When your head coach comes in and says, hey, all gas, no brakes and all that kind of jazz. Dude, I'm like, number one, I thought that was brilliant. Damn it, I need to come in there and I'm going to come in with all gas, no brakes. That's a great slogan to get you a head coaching job. But we're seeing what it looks like if your quarterback's playing with all gas, no brakes.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus right now.